their operations. They literally designed it on the drawing board and used on a very high tail for its stability. Two turbine engines, extremely powerful. Seen a lot of the Vietnam War and used by several air forces all throughout the world. Wind resistant windshield, self-sealing fuel tanks. Broncos were operated in Germany and Thailand, Venezuela, Indonesia. Let's have a good look, get your cameras out, photo opportunity here as the Bronco comes hard round onto the ground line. This is the phrase, lest we forget. This aircraft is involved in the spreading and distribution of poppy seeds, which can be found at air show displays where the Bronco is displaying on the ground as well. The idea being, of course, is to promote the growing of poppies so that we don't forget those who've fallen in wartime. A lovely view of the aeroplane here. And he's done a lot of work, television commercials. If you want a car dropped off an aeroplane, he's your man. Tony has photographed from his aircraft the Vickersville, the Vulcan, Typhoon, very, very keen aerial photographer, well known in aviation circles for his photography. And Tony reckons he's locked up over 300 hours now flying the Bronco, displaying for us this unusual aircraft. Imagine coming at you in battle. Munitions fully loaded, contain paratrooper stretchers and loiter. It says here, loiter to more than 3 hours. And this is known in the trade as a SCOL aircraft, S-T-O-L, short takeoff and landing. It's the acronym that we use for that. And this, although we won't see it today, it's got very, very good short takeoff capability. First flew in 1965 at Rockwell in Columbus, Ohio, at their base where it was put. And many, many roles in the American configuration, including armed reconnaissance, ground attack, tactical air operation, low-level air photography. And it's communicated with torpedo tools, nothing special, no ground equipment is required to start the engines. And they will run on high-octane car fuel if need be. So a real versatile aeroplane. It's been restored to flying condition by Tony de Bruyn for our enjoyment this afternoon. Four machine guns would have been fitted. M60Cs, if you know your machine guns, I'm sure you do. And rats to carry weapons, keep those cameras keep hopefully bring you properties from farmers to air shows all over Europe this year, and they're supporting a message of peace and reconciliation in the remembrance of the First World War over 100 years ago, of course. And this team is based in Belgium, and they feel I know quite well. And this is Ypres. And it was used the airfield in the First World War and eventually by the Royal Flying Corps and the Royal Air Force. And you may catch that traffic, lest we forget as it comes by, if you've got a good, strong lens on your camera. Okay, it's the last pass by the Bronco this afternoon, closing the real 2017 air show. Let's give them a wave, let's get those cameras clicking as we see a rare sight of this 1960s versatile war machine restored by Tony DeBruyne.